Samsung One UI 4 is finally here. I installed the One UI Beta 1 on my S21 Ultra and I have a lot to share with you guys. Before I take you ahead, hit that subscribe button to show your support. First things first, the One UI 4 Beta is based on the Android 12 as you can see right on your screen. Now, rotating this clock is supposed to give you an Easter egg, but that doesn't appear right now. I believe that it will appear in upcoming versions of this One UI. At the time of making this video, this Beta 1 UI has rolled out only for the S21 series in a few select countries. I installed this manually and let me know if you guys need a tutorial on the same. I'll try to make one. When I updated my phone and plugged in the charger, this new animation popped up and I liked it. Change sometimes is good and I think the old animation was a bit boring. Anyways, let's go ahead and start right off with the lock screen of the phone. You can set always on display to turn up every time you receive a notification now. There are some new animations for the always on display. If you are playing music via Samsung Music Player or any other player for that matter, you can choose the device through the media output button. This will let you switch between multiple sound output devices right from the lock screen. If you open the voice recorder on the phone and leave it open, lock the screen, a widget appears on the lock screen which will let you record without unlocking the phone. You can also track your monthly events using the lock screen calendar widget now. Let's talk about the quick panel. First of all, the brightness bar has been redesigned. It's large enough to easily swipe your finger on it. There are some new toggles, the camera, mic, and a couple of other toggles. Using these toggles, you can turn on or off the camera or mic access altogether for all applications at once, or you can even view which applications are using your camera and mic and turn off the access for only those applications. I'll explain this further when we talk about the privacy. The new extra dim feature does what its name suggests. You can turn on or off the extra dim using the accessibility button that appears on the lower right corner after the One UI 4 update, and obviously you can remove this button from the buttons tray as well. Dark mode has now deep integration. It tries to turn everything dark, including the wallpaper icons. You can see these folders, the illustrations, even the tiniest elements now turn dark. It enforces the dark mode in all the applications regardless of the dark mode support. It looks lovely now and I have started liking the dark mode once again. I actually stopped using the dark mode a while ago, but I think I am going to use it once again. Home screen changes include the widgets redesign. Widgets now appear like this. They look more sorted and it's easy to reach out to your desired widget. It also recommends the useful widgets. Obviously, there are a lot of widgets that have been enhanced as well. The dual clock widget now shows different background colors depending on whether it's day or night in a country or city. Samsung has enhanced the keyboard. It looks like Samsung was largely inspired by the Google keyboard and we can find some similarities here. You can access the emojis, the GIFs and stickers by tapping this single button now. Furthermore, you can combine two emojis to create a new animation in the form of a GIF. This, to be honest, looks very cool. We have some new stickers and yeah, the keyboard is now powered by Grammarly Writing Assistant to improve your English. We saw the option to customize sharing panel when we talked about the GoodLock 2021 on our channel. That feature has made its way to the One UI 4. You can now customize the sharing screen and select what apps you want on this panel. I am going to remove some clutter from this screen. Also, the app icons now appear in the form of this horizontal tray. They appeared in the grid form previously. The file manager has got a new look. You can see new icons for the options inside the file manager. Samsung has added some colors to highlight the options here. There are many other tiny changes that you may notice upon using this One UI. Samsung's major focus has remained on the privacy. Now, whenever an application accesses your phone's microphone or camera, its icon appears on the top right corner. You can decide to turn off the camera or mic support for the apps you don't feel comfortable with. Permissions have improved a lot now. I am the kind of a guy who doesn't like a lot of notifications cluttering my notifications panel, and every new app I installed, it just added more to the clutter. Thankfully, Samsung has now brought this feature that asks you whether or not you want to allow notifications from specific application when you install it. This by far has been my favorite feature in the One UI 4, and I decided to keep the notifications turned off for more than 70% of the applications installed on my phone. When you make calls, you find an overall call menu UI. If you go into the contacts and type a contact's name, the text appears bold in the search menu. Some nice touches include a new animation when you send someone a message in any chat application. There are the tiny little details that are not mentioned in the changelog of the new Android 12 One UI 4. I am using this UI, and as I discover more features, I'll keep you guys informed. For now, I'll just continue with the changelog. Samsung has made some significant changes to the camera application. When you open the camera app in the One UI 4, it shows you 0.6x, 1x, 3x or 10x instead of the ultra-wide normal and the zoom icons. Scene optimizer icon no longer appears for the normal photos. It only appears when it's too dark and you need the night mode. Front camera's wide and ultra-wide selfie icons have been changed as well. Video recording starts right when you tap the recording button. There is no delay now. You can drag your finger on the shutter button in the photo mode to start recording a video and lock the recording. Single take mode now gives you a better control over the options. You can also deselect some options in the single take mode. Pro mode has been overhauled as well. The UI first of all looks cleaner. The grid lines help you make your frame horizontally perfect. Gallery app's story feature now shows a cover with a video preview. The sorting of large albums is now enhanced with the new options. Album cover is shown on the top when you open a specific album. You can revert the remastered pictures to their original form even after saving those pictures. Lastly, you can edit the date, time, and location of the photos and videos in the gallery application. You can create collage videos by combining photos and videos together. There is a light balance option to edit the tone of pictures. Highlight Reel Editor now gives you more control. You can also revert the edited videos back to their original form. You can now cut a face, building, pet, or any other object and paste it onto a different one. Samsung has also made some changes to the AR emoji feature. You can use AR emoji as a profile picture for the contacts in the Samsung account. Over 10 different expressions are now available. There are new AR emoji stickers. You can create dance videos with the AR emojis and use your own drawings to create clothes and outlooks for the emojis. Pin window option now appears right here in the multitasking menu. No need to enable it from the settings separately. You can keep the current window in view while accessing the edge panels. They used to get blurred back in the day. In the settings of the phone, we have a new safety and emergency tab. Here, you can add your medical info, emergency contacts, and SOS messages now appear here. Changes inside the calendar application include a layout that lets you add events instantly. The monthly calendar widget shows important events too. Now create shared calendars and invite other Galaxy users to join too. The Messages app now supports images, videos, web links, and a lot of other content in the search window. Samsung has largely improved the Samsung Internet application. It gives you more suggestions as you type in the address bar, and its new search widget will let you find anything right from the home screen. If you were using the Samsung Internet in the private mode last time and you shut it down, the next time you open it, it will open in the private mode again to protect your privacy. The device care also gets an overhaul. Main screen now shows battery and security issues and suggestions to apply the fixes. The status of phone's health is shown in the form of emojis. You can also access the Samsung member diagnostics to perform diagnostic tests to find out issues in your phone. Samsung Health shows you a new bottom tab carrying useful features. A new My Page tab has been added. This page shows all of your personal information and progress. Snacks are now a part of the food tracker. You can invite friends and family to various challenges now. New routines have been added. You can now perform more tasks in the phone using the Bixby routines. Samsung has also removed the restrictions for some condition combinations to give you the freedom. New accessibility options have been added to the phone. You can adjust the contrast and size at the same time with the custom display mode. Accessibility features can be accessed quickly via floating button. I already explained the extra dim option. You can set a different color for the notifications of each application. A new magnification menu has been added, which now incorporates a magnifier window. The most important thing towards the end, the privacy. Not just Samsung's One UI, but the focus of Android itself has largely remained on the privacy this year around. As I mentioned earlier, you can now view which app is accessing the camera or mic. You can turn off the mic or camera access for all the applications. Furthermore, you can take more control on the location access of certain applications. You can set location access to precise for the applications you don't fully trust. Lastly, if you copy passwords, codes, and any other sensitive information to the clipboard and you don't want those to fall into the wrong hands, you can view what applications are trying to access your clipboard and save yourself from some trouble. One thing I have not mentioned in this entire video is the improvement of the search feature. In almost all the applications, Samsung has enhanced the search function and it is now more efficient. The search improvement was mentioned again and again throughout the changelog, which is why I decided not to mention it again and again in this video. This is it with the changelog and prominent changes. There is definitely a lot more to discover in the One UI 4, and new features will keep landing in as Samsung rolls out further beta versions of the One UI. And I'll be doing a number of follow-up videos. To catch all of my upcoming videos, hit the subscribe button and drop a like. Let me know about your thoughts on this video and obviously the Samsung One UI 4. With that being said, I will sign off and see you all in the next one.